Hey y'all, Tony from Ropes and Wings. Merry Christmas. We're only a day out from Christmas when I recorded this, and it is cold here in East Tennessee. I hope you all are staying warm, enjoying time with friends and family. But I just wanted to get on here today and introduce this next session. This is the last session of the year, and it was beautiful healing session, very high vibrational session, and I wanted to share that. We did a few amazing soul rescues, and then we went and saw A Lifetime as a Mermaid Being, and that was so very emotional. The next scene we saw, we were in the in-between times, in between incarnations. We got some messages from God's, from Source. And in that in-between time, a lot of healing was occurring. And those high vibrational frequency scenes, I always feel like when I come out of them that there are so many other questions that I wanted to ask and I didn't get a chance to because just flowing with the way the session was supposed to go. But it was an amazing session. So I hope you enjoy watching this. I want to thank my client for allowing me to share this session with you. It was an amazing session. If I don't talk to you till then, Merry Christmas. Have a wonderful new year. It's going to be an epic 2023. We're going into it. It's going to be great. And remember that I still have the Holiday 15 discount code that you can use on booking a session and of any of our other products that we have on the website. I'll have all the links in the description if you'd like to book a session with me or would like to get in contact with me. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to the channel so you can keep up to date on anything going on. And hope you enjoy. Have a Merry Christmas. I love you all. Have a wonderful new year. Pass your awareness down the body, starting at the head, and let me know if you find anything.
Right hand around my thumb.
And what sensation do you get in the right hand around your thumb?
Like a tension.
Let's have Archangel Michael place his net of white light around this tension in the right thumb, all the way around where this energy exists, all the way around. And as we focus deeper on this tension in the right thumb, if it had a color, what color would it be?
Blue.
I would like to speak to this blue energy causing tension in the right thumb. I'd like to speak to this energy. If it had anything to say, what would it say?
No.
Why are you telling me no?
I don't know.
What are you doing there in this one?
Hurting.
Why are you hurting her?
I don't know.
Do you ever remember a time of having a human body?
Maybe.
Yes. Let's have the angels gather around you so they can help you focus on this time that you had the human body. As you come out of the human body, you have a name that I can call you?
Jewel.
Jewel. How old are you, Jewel?
Seven.
Hello, sweetie. What year is it for you, Jewel?
46.
And Jewel, do you remember what happened to your human body in 1946? What caused you to come out of it?
I fell.
And where was it that you fell?
From a tree.
And what part of your body was impacted the most when you fell?
My arm.
And your arm. And was that what caused you to come out of your human body?
I got hung by my arm.
I see. Tell me what happened next when you got hung by your arm.
It broke.
And when your arm broke, when was it that you realized that you came out of the human body?
While I was hanging there.
Yes.
I'm not there.
I see. And then after you come out of the human body, while that body was hanging there in that tree, where did you do next? Where'd you go?
I only stayed in the tree.
I see. You stayed there in the tree.
Yes.
And Jewel, how did you find this one? What attracted you to this one?
She used to climb trees.
I see. And what attracted you to her when she was climbing those trees?
She liked to lay in it. It's her favorite tree.
Beautiful. Let's have Archangel Gabriel and Kuan Yin help this soul, help heal this soul. She is whole. Jewel is whole. Jewel, when you attached to this one, what was she going through in her life when she was laying in the tree?
I don't know.
I see. I'm just attached to her.
She was there.
Yes. And you needed a place to be. You didn't know where to go.
Yes.
And Jewel, I know it's not your fault, but since you've attached to her, what issues have you been causing this one?
I like to move around.
Do you? And so when you move around, what happens to her body?
It hurts. I'm telling her I'm around.
Yes. You're trying to get her attention.
Yes.
Beautiful. Well, you have our attention now. We're here to help you, Jewel. Is there any other issues that you caused this one since you've attached?
Oh, all over her. Just move.
Yes.
It's fun.
And give me some more of those issues that you do when you move around. Just the pain?
Pain. Muscles. It makes her massage it. It makes me feel good.
I see. And do you affect her neck as well?
No.
I see. Beautiful. Well, Jewel, we're here to help you today. We want to help you heal and move to where you need to go back home. Are you ready for us to help you?
I like her.
I understand you like her. She's kept you safe for a very long time. Can I show you where you need to go?
No.
What do you?
Maybe.
Yes, let's have the angels give you a message. What do the angels tell you about detaching from this one?
Good.
What else do they tell you?
Light.
Yes.
Home.
And when they show you that home, what do you think of that?
Mom.
Yes. Beautiful. Let's go speak to your mom. Jewel, what I want you today to do is on that day that you fell out of the tree and you hung there and you come out of the human body, instead of finding this one or staying in that tree, what I want you to do is I want you to look around for the lightest source. Look all the way around you for the lightest source. It'll draw you towards it like many, many magnets. Tell me when you find that light.
Yes.
You see that light? Now the angels are going to help you, Jewel, and you can look into that light. When you look into that light, Who do you see there waiting for you?
Mom.
What does your mother say to you, Joel?
I love you.
Beautiful. What else does she say?
Come.
How do you feel about that, Joel?
I want to go.
Beautiful. We're going to help you out of this one so you can go to your mom. I am going to count backwards from 3 to 1. We're going to send a pulse of blue light through the net. This is going to tickle a little bit, but this is going to help you to detach from this one. And I want you to help the angels place all your energy into that net you're wrapped in, placing it all in there. And I want this one to feel this energy of Jewel lifting off as we do this. 3, sending the pulse of blue light through the net. Detaching. The angels are helping Jewel place her energy into the net. Beautiful. It's all in the net now. Let's gently lift out now. 2, almost out. And 1, out of the light of source with her mother. But before you go, Jewel, what do you want to tell this one?
I had fun.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry.
Beautiful. You go to your mother. Is there anything this one would like to tell this beautiful soul of Jewel before she goes?
Have peace.
Beautiful. And as we cut the final cord between these two, cutting that final cord, and we watch Jewel go into the light of source with her mother, what color light can we place there for healing?
Yellow.
Beautiful. And as I strike the tuning fork for the color yellow, I want you to place that frequency there. Placing it there where everywhere that Jewel was attached. As that frequency flows in there, the pain subsides and lifts away. The dense feelings fall away that were not ours. Cells, as that swirls outward, the cells come back online, no longer experiencing the pain that was not ours. We can have Kuan Yin and Raphael assist with the healing with this. Beautiful. How does that feel now that we lifted that off?
Good.
Beautiful. As they continue to heal those areas, let's continue with our scan and scan down the body, looking for any low-level dark energy that should not be there, any energy that should not be there, any pain or discomfort, feelings or sensation. Go ahead.
Lower back.
And what sensation do you get in the lower back?
Dull.
Mm-hmm.
Dull pain. It's not really pain.
Mm-hmm. This dull ache in the lower back. We'll have Archangel Michael place his net of white light around this dull ache in the lower back, all the way around where this energy is attached. And as we focus deeper on this energy, what color do you sense this to be?
Dark.
And I'd like to speak to this dark energy causing the ache, dull ache in the lower back. I'd like to speak to it. What is it you're doing there? If you have anything to say, what would you say?
Hanging out.
I understand you're hanging out in this one. This is a free will universe and you don't have permission to be there. What are you doing there just hanging out?
I don't like her.
Why is it that you don't like her?
She's light.
And who sent you here to keep her light down?
I'm not saying.
Why didn't you want to tell me?
Because you're evil.
I'm evil. I'd like to know about your story and how you got there. It's pretty clever.
It's put there.
Yes, and who put you there?
Someone I don't want to tell you.
I see. Well, whoever told you had lied and deceived you.
What is no. It
that, no, you don't agree?
I have the truth.
Beautiful. Well, tell me what you're doing there in this one.
Watching.
You're watching. What else are you doing? How do you keep her light down?
I don't let her know she's light.
I see. I see. And how do you do that? How do you keep her from knowing she's light?
I give negative thoughts.
And so you put the negative thoughts in her head?
Yes.
What else do you do?
Make her think bad things.
Yes. What else?
Keep her from light.
Why do you want to keep her from the light?
I was told to.
And what did whoever sent you tell you about the light? What they say about that light?
Evil.
And do you take her energy from her as well?
Yes.
And do you feed that back to whoever sent you?
Yes.
So you're taking her energy, making her feel tired all the time. And explain this to me. Does this make sense to you? That if whoever told you or sent you here told you to not like the light, fear the light.
I don't fear the light.
Yes. Well, they told you the light was evil. So if that light was so evil, why is it that you're using the energy off the light? Does that make sense?
I don't understand.
Yes. Well, you need the light to survive. And no. So does... Yes, you're taking her energy and light.
I eat it.
Yes, you do. You take it. But you eat the light. So if the light is that bad, why would they tell you that it's evil? Does that make sense to you?
No.
No, it doesn't. Because whoever that sent you had lied and deceived you into doing this to keep her light down. So that way you keep doing this job.
I because do good.
You do good, but they think you're less than them.
No.
Would you like to be more powerful than the ones who sent you?
I am powerful.
Would you like to be even more powerful, just like we are?
Yes.
Beautiful. Is there any other issues that you caused this one? How is it that you keep her light down? How else do you do this? You take her energy. You put thoughts in her head.
Headaches.
And the headaches, yes. And how do you put the headache? How do you cause the headaches?
I manipulate her brain.
And so are you connected to her system? Is that how you're able to
manipulate the brain? Spine. Yes.
Tell me, how do you look? What does your beingness look like? What do you look like?
I have horns. I have red eyes.
Yes.
And I have claws and a tail. Dark.
Yes. And beautiful. And do you do this all yourself? Or are you with
others?
And what do those others look like?
Like me.
And how do you control the others? You tell them what to do?
Yes.
Yes. So you're controlling all these others and telling them what to do in this one?
Mostly.
And so do you speak for these others that are there?
Sometimes.
Yes. And what else do these others do to this one? What do you have them do?
Neck pain, stomach aches, eat.
Yes. May you make her eat?
Yeah.
What is that accomplished by making her eat?
Yes.
And then she has self-doubt and thoughts because of the weight that was put on. It's funny, yeah. Isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
You're pretty clever.
I am.
What else do you do? What else do you make these others do?
Cause issues. Oh, scratchies.
Mm-hmm. I see. Let's make sure. Let's have Archangel Michael places that a white light around centers, all around all the energy centers of this one, completely around where these energies of the others that this one controls is attached.
No.
Beautiful. We just have you wrapped in this net. It's beautiful white light.
No.
It's beautiful white light. Let's have the angels that gather around you and the others that you control. What do they tell? They have a message for you. What do they tell you you can expect if you detach from this one?
Light.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want light.
What do they tell you about this light?
That it'll be good.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want it.
Yes. Let's have the angels show this one and the others. Show everyone here that this one controls this. This energy we're talking to. Let's have the. What is it now?
I don't want this. Mm-hmm. I need to be here.
I understand that you feel like you have a job to do, but this is a free will universe and you don't have permission to be there.
I do.
No, just like the one who sent you here didn't have permission to send you here and make you do this job. What do the angels show you your journey will look like after you detach from this one?
Clouds. I see clouds.
Mm-hmm.
Blue sky, white light.
And what does that blue sky and clouds remind you of?
Heaven.
Mm-hmm. What else?
Wait, I shouldn't know what that is.
Right. Right. And the reason that you do know what that is because that is home.
Oh.
And you forgot that.
I did.
Mm-hmm. What are the others that you control?
Bastards.
Yes. They deceived you and lied to you. You told me.
Fuckers.
Mm-hmm. What do the others think about this? What do they think?
They want to go. They don't want to stay. They want to leave.
Beautiful. And can we show you the light that you have within you that you lost?
Yes.
Beautiful. Now I want everyone that you control, I want you all to focus in your own beingness. Focus deep inside your beingness. You'll find that tiny spark, the spark of source. Tell me when everyone has found that spark.
Okay.
Let's expand that spark. Let's expand the spark out in everyone. This is your own power source. This is your own food source. Let's expand it out to completely wrap you in this light.
Mm.
How does that light feel?
Warm.
Beautiful. You forgot this, haven't you?
Yes.
And does everyone that you control feel the same way?
Mostly.
Tell me about mostly. Who's?
There's someone hiding.
Mm-hmm. Who is this that's hiding?
I don't know. I don't know how many I have.
Mm-hmm. And so,
it's little. It's tiny.
And do you control this one that's hiding?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Are you connected to him?
A hair.
Mm-hmm. Can you speak to it? Can you tell it what you're experiencing and help him show it?
Come here.
Beautiful. Help them to experience what you're feeling with the light. Let's expand their light out as well. What do they think about that?
They're apprehensive.
Mm-hmm. Let's have the angels give them a message of what they can expect if they detach. What do the angels tell them?
Happy. Love.
Yes.
It's coming. He's very little, like a baby.
But we're going to help this little one out. We can help this little one out.
He's here.
And is this one of the ones that you control, or is this a lost soul?
I'm lost.
And did this one, this lost soul, have a story that they need to tell?
Lost.
Let me see.
He doesn't know where he came from.
And were you controlling this one as well, having him
do? No, I wasn't. He's been hiding.
Where was he hiding at?
Shoulder.
Let's go ahead and let's have Archangel Michael wrap his net of white light around this lost one, this little lost one that's there, and we can talk to them and get that story in that right shoulder, all the way around where that energy is attached. Now we have the net of white light around all the energy centers of this one, so we're talking to this energy, this dark energy that was controlling others. Does everyone that you control, are they agreed to go to the light?
Yes.
Are they ready to go?
Yes.
Beautiful. What we're going to do is I'm going to count backwards from 3 to 1. We're going to send a pulse of blue light through the net. This is going to help detach everyone from this one. We're going to place all of our energy into the net and help everyone get into the net. Help the angels put your energy into the net. And I want this one to feel this energy lift off as we do this. 3, sending that pulse of light through the net, pulsing through. Everybody is detaching their energy. Everyone is on board. They're all placing their energy into the net. The angels are helping. Beautiful. Everything's in the net. Let's gently lift out now. 2, almost out. And 1, out in the light of source with the angels. But before you all go, is there anything that you would like to tell this one?
We're sorry.
Beautiful, beautiful. Is there anything that this one would like to tell these energies before they go?
Good luck. Be happy.
Beautiful. Let's cut that final cord between all of these energies that were doing ill will to us. Cutting that final cord and sending them off with love into the light of source with the angels so they can heal and continue on their journey. And as they move on to their journey, let's go back to that right shoulder, that little energy that we had in the right, in the shoulder, that left shoulder. Let's speak to it. If it had anything to say, what would it say?
I needed a home.
I understand you needed a home, and we're here to help you out so you can find your way back home. Tell me more about you.
I don't know about me.
Did you ever continue?
I don't know where I came from.
Let's have the angels gather around you. They're going to help you to focus and remember. Do you ever remember a time of having a human body?
No. Maybe. I don't know.
Yes, and the angels will help you. We'll have Archangel Gabriel and Kuan Yin assist you to help heal you so you can focus on that time you had a human body. What color are you?
Pink.
Beautiful pink. And when we go back to that time that you had a human body, what name did they used to call you? Did you have a name?
Betty.
Betty. It's nice to meet you, Betty. What? How old are you, Betty?
17.
Betty, at 17
years. Oh my God, car crash.
Yes. What year is it for you, Betty?
52.
And in this car crash, Betty, Were you driving the car?
No.
Mm-hmm. Who was driving the car?
My boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
He drank.
Yes. And was there anybody else in the car with you?
No.
No. What happened that caused the car to crash?
Tree.
Yes. And you hit a tree?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What part of your body was impacted the most?
My shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
But it hit my head and killed me.
I see. Well, the angels that are gathered around you, Archangel Raphael, is going to help you to heal. You are whole. You just don't have the body right now at this time, so they're healing you, trying to heal that pain in that shoulder. Beautiful. And when, after the car crash, after you hit the tree and you come out of the human body, what happened next? What'd you do next?
I saw myself.
Mm-hmm.
In the car.
Yes.
It was mangled.
Mm-hmm. And what
I
about?
I floated.
Yes.
I floated around.
Mm-hmm. Where'd you go?
Just floated around.
Mm-hmm.
For a long time.
Yes. And what about your boyfriend? Is he there with you or did he?
I don't know where he is.
Okay. Beautiful. Beautiful. And then you were floating around. How was it that you were able to find this one? How'd you find this one?
I'm not sure.
Mm-hmm. What attracted you to her?
She was with friends.
Yes. And what was she going through in her life that attracted you to her?
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm.
They were playing in the playground.
Yes.
And they were pretending or trying to hyperventilate each other.
Mm-hmm.
I found her.
I see.
That's when I did it.
Uh-huh. What were you trying to do when you attached to her?
I needed something.
Mm-hmm. You needed a new vehicle?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I see. And Betty, I know that you didn't mean to because you were just trying to find a place to be.
Years.
What's
I floated for years.
Yes, you were just trying to find a place to be. But I know you didn't mean to, but what issues have you been causing this one since you attached? You caused the pain in the shoulder and the neck as well?
I don't know if I did the neck.
Mm, I see. Because the pain in the shoulders, or any other issues that you caused her?
Shoulders just been recent.
Mm-hmm.
Stomach issues.
Yes. So you've been causing her stomach issues?
Yes.
What kind of stomach issues? So we can help you both heal.
Digestive issues.
Yes.
Diarrhea.
Sorry, that's happening. Anything else?
Foot.
The foot?
Yeah, every once in a while I'll play with her feet.
Yeah, why do you do that?
To tell her I'm here, but she doesn't know that.
Yes. Takes a while for them to realize. Any other issues that we need to help heal you and help heal this one that you've caused?
Hearing.
Mm-hmm. What do you do with it?
I'm ringing her ear right now.
Are you?
Uh-huh.
Is it just to get her attention or are you causing?
Just to show her I'm here.
Uh-huh. I see. Anything else that we can help you heal with?
I want my boyfriend.
I understand you do. We're going to help you out in a little bit, but we want to find out what we need to heal in this one, too, that you've been causing. So with the stomach issues also too, are you causing her to eat certain things?
No.
I see. Beautiful. What I want you to do is on that day, are you ready to go detach from this one and go back home?
I want to see my boyfriend.
Yes. So, Betty, on that day that you come out of the human body in that car crash, when you hit that tree and you hit your shoulder and your neck, what I want you to do, instead of floating around and not having a place to be and then finding this one, I want you to look around on that day. I want you to look around for the lightest source that'll draw you towards it like many, many magnets. Tell me when you find that light.
I found it.
You found that light? Why didn't you go to that light on that day?
I was scared.
Mm-hmm. You were young. You didn't know where to be. Why were you scared of the light?
It looked weird.
Mm-hmm. I see.
I saw my body. I saw that. It scared me and I took off.
Mm-hmm. I see. And so I want you to focus in to that light. I want you to look in that light. And the angels are going to help you to focus in on that light. Who do you see there waiting for you to guide you home?
My boyfriend.
Yes. What does he say to you?
Come with me.
Mm-hmm. What else does he say?
It's great here.
Mm-hmm.
You'll love it.
Let's ask the angels. Let's ask the angels if this is what you should do. What do they say?
Yes.
This is the proper light. This is the lightest source.
Yes.
Yes. Let's ask your boyfriend, how did he transition on that day?
He hit his head on the steering wheel.
I see. And then he went into the light?
Yes.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Well, let's help you out, Betty. Let's get you out of there so you can rejoin your boyfriend. In a moment, I'm going to send a pulse of blue light through the net we have you wrapped in. This is going to help you to detach, Betty. I'd like you to place all your energy into that net so we can lift you out. Help the angels put your energy in there so we can lift you out of there. I want this one to feel this energy of Betty lift off as we do this. Three, sending that pulse of blue light through the net. Might tickle a little bit, but it's helping you to detach. Place all your energy into the net. Help the angels get it all into the net so we can lift you out. Beautiful. It's all in the net now. We're ready to move. Let's gently lift out now. Two, almost out. And one, out in the light of source with her boyfriend. But before you go, Betty, is there anything you would like to tell this one?
It's been fun.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. Go ahead.
Bye.
Beautiful. Is there anything this one would like to tell this beautiful soul of Betty?
Have a good life with your boyfriend.
Yes.
Beautiful. Love to you.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. As we cut that final cord between these two, cutting that final cord between these two, we watch Betty go into the light of source to heal and continue on her journey. What color light would signify healing for you that we can put in those areas of the lower back where all those other ones were attached as well?
Green.
Beautiful. As we strike the tuning fork for the color green, we're going to ask Archangel Raphael to assist us with the healing. This is his ray. I want you to place that frequency into all those areas. Fill them all in with that frequency. Those lower density feelings and pain and things that were not ours, just falling away. Just falling away. As that your connection comes back, the pain disappears. Your self-confidence, your inner power, no longer being controlled anymore as those cells come back online, as that frequency swirls outward. How does that feel?
Good.
Beautiful. Beautiful. And let's, as they continue to heal those areas, all those areas, let's continue with our scan and scan down the body, looking for any low level energy. Should not be there. Pain or discomfort.
Shoulders still.
Shoulders. Beautiful. And what sensation do you get in the shoulders?
Kind of a dull pain. Mm-hmm. Constant. It wasn't there a minute ago.
Mm-hmm. This dull pain in the shoulders, let's have Archangel Michael place his net of white light around the dull pain in the shoulders. And is this dull pain in the shoulders, as we focus in on it, is this connected to the neck as well?
Other side.
I see. What color do you sense with the dull pain in the shoulders?
Kind of a muddy green.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to speak to this muddy green energy that's causing the dull pain in the shoulders. What are you doing there in this one?
I'm hiding.
Mm-hmm. Why are you hiding?
I don't want to be found.
I understand. Do you ever remember a time of having a human body?
No, I'm a frog.
Mm. I see. And who sent you here to attach to this one?
Me.
You did? And what is it you're hiding now, trying to hide from me, but what is it that you're doing there in this one?
Watching.
Uh-huh. What are you watching for?
See what she does.
Yes. And when you find out what she does, what do you do with this information?
Take it.
Take it where?
To my guy.
Who's your guy? Who sent you there?
All powerful.
Yes. What does he do with this information?
Gives it to someone else.
Mm-hmm.
Who's very powerful.
Yes. So you're gaining information on this one. But what do they do with that information? What kind of information are you gathering?
I want to know what she's learning.
Mm-hmm.
We don't want her to learn.
Yes. So then when she learns something or sees something that you don't want her to see or learn, what do you do then?
I tell her that it's not true.
Mm-hmm.
And then I tell my boss. And they gather info or information.
Mm-hmm. And so you're putting thoughts in her head then too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And do you feed off of her energy?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. This makes her tired when you're taking her energy?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
They take it from me.
Uh-huh.
So I'm tired too.
Yes, I understand that. What other issues do you cause this one since you attached to her?
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Anything else so we can help you heal?
I'm just an information gatherer.
I see. And how was it that you were able to attach to her? What was going on in her life when you were able to attach?
Internet.
Mm-hmm.
She was learning things.
Yes. And how were you able to attach through the internet? How'd that happen?
Reading.
Mm-hmm. I see.
There was an opening somehow. I took it.
Yeah. So what was going on in her life while she was reading on the internet that allowed you to attach? What was going on in her life?
I Sex.
I see. And what was wrong with this sex?
It was, I don't know. It just opened and I took it.
I see.
Reading a book online, I think.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Let's have the angels. They're going to gather around you. They're going to let you know and give you a message of what you can expect if you detach from this one. What do they tell you?
Could be better.
Mm-hmm. Ask them. What else they say?
Light.
Yes.
Hi. Light. Yellow. Mm-hmm. Yellow light.
What do you think about this light?
Air. It's like the sun.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about this light?
I'm not used to it. I get different light from this person.
Yes, I understand. What are the ones that send you say about this light?
It'll be good for me. I'll like it. Mm-hmm. And it will be for myself.
Is that what the angels told you that?
Yeah, I don't have to give it away.
Yeah, beautiful. Yeah, it'll be your own internal power source.
Yeah.
What do you think about that? Are you ready to go with the angels? Yes. Beautiful. What I'd like you to do is we can find that light within you. I want you to look deep inside your beingness. It'll be a tiny spark. You lost it or told you probably never had it.
I see it.
You see that light?
Pinprick.
Yes. Let's expand that light out to be larger than what you are. Let's wrap you in that, your own internal power source. How does that feel?
Great.
Beautiful. Are you ready to go?
Yeah.
Beautiful. In a moment, I'm going to count backwards from 3 to 1. And as I count backwards from 3 to 1, we're going to send a pulse of blue light through the net. This is going to help you to detach from this one. I want you to help the angels place all your energy into that net so we can gently lift you out. And I want this one to take all her energy back as we do this and feel this energy lift off. 3, sending the pulse of blue light swirling through the net now. Detaching the angels and this energy's placing his energy into the net. It's all in the net now. Let's gently lift out now. 2, almost out, and 1 out in the light of source. But before you go, is there anything you would like to tell this one?
I'm sorry for taking your energy.
Beautiful. Thank you. Is there anything this one would like to tell this beautiful energy before it goes?
Thank you for leaving.
Beautiful. And let's cut that final cord. Let's cut that final cord between these two. And as we watch that energy move into the light of source with the angels, how does that feel now?
Better.
Beautiful, beautiful. Let's focus on that neck area now. Let's have Archangel Michael place his net of white light around that neck area. What sensation do you get there in the neck area?
Warmth now.
Mm-hmm. With that net of white light around the warmth?
Yes.
Beautiful. And what else do you notice about that neck area?
Tight.
Mm-hmm. And that tightness in the neck. What color do you sense this tightness to be?
Indigo.
Mm-hmm. And as we focus deeper, I'd like to speak to this energy there in the neck causing the tightness. If it had anything to say, what would it say?
3. I'm a tree.
Yes. Tell me more about yourself. How are you a tree?
I have tentacles.
I see. And who sent you here to be in this one?
I've always been here.
Yes. Tell me more about that. How have you always been there?
As long as I can remember, I've been here. Hmm.
And did you attach to her in another lifetime?
I think maybe so.
Yes. So the angels are going to gather. They're gathered around you. They're going to help you to focus so we can get your story. These tentacles. Tell me more about how you got attached to this one. How were you able to get in there?
I don't remember. I'm part of her.
Yes. Who sent you here to do this? Who sent you here to be here?
God. My God.
Yes, your God sent you there. I see. And what is it that he sent you there to do?
It's been a long time. My God forgot me.
Yes, he did. But what did they send you there to do? What do you do in this one?
I'm part of her.
Yes. You're part of her, but what were you sent? What was your mission? What were you supposed to do? What were you sent there by your God?
I don't remember. Why can't I remember?
To have the angels that are gathered around you, they're going to help you with that memory. Your whole, so you can remember how you got there. What do they say to you?
Remember.
What else do they say?
They're giving me light.
Yes. Beautiful.
Warm hands. Light.
Yes.
I want her light.
Beautiful. So you take her light?
Yes.
And you're there in the neck. What else do you do? How do you take her light?
I hold it. I don't have anybody to give it to anymore. I just hold it into my tentacles.
What other issues do you cause this one since you've attached?
Neck. Upper body, back, shoulders, a tree that goes all the way down her back, shoulders.
Yes. And what does this tree do? Does it just cause pain, or does it?
Yes.
Yes. And this keeps her light from shining, and you hold that light.
Yes.
Yes. Do you feed off this light?
That's how I live.
Yeah, because you need the light. You forgot that because your God didn't want you to realize that.
Yes.
And he left you there.
Long time.
Now, with your tentacles, do you reach out and grab other energies and light?
Dog.
A dog. Tell me about that.
Dog's light. Dog's very light.
Yes.
I like to touch.
So you touch the dog?
It makes me feel good.
I see. Is there any other issues that you caused this one besides pain and taking her energy?
No.
Let's have the angel show you what your journey is going to look like after you detach from this one. It's been so long you forgot what you're even doing here.
Hundreds, thousands, years long. Yes. Time.
And what did the angels say of how you attached and came through all this time?
Trauma.
Yes. Yes.
Years. Mm-hmm. Hang.
And why did you target this one?
It came with. I came with.
I see.
So many times. Mm-hmm.
Beautiful. Thank you for that. That'll help us to heal. We're going to help heal you now. The angels to give you a message on what you can expect if you detach from this one. Where are you going to go and where's your journey going to lead you to?
Forest.
Uh-huh.
Green. Mm-hmm. Sunlight, yellow,
beautiful
leaves,
uh-huh.
Ground grass,
beautiful. What do you feel? How do you feel about that?
I want to be a tree.
Beautiful. Beautiful. And are you ready to help us have you help you get you out of this one?
Yes, I want to go.
Beautiful. What I want you to do is I want you to look inside your deep inside your beingness, deep inside that tree. Is that tiny spark? A tiny spark that you have missed.
It's in my heart. I see it. I feel it.
Beautiful. Let's expand that spark out to be larger than what you are. Completely wrap you in that own internal power source all the way around you. How does that light feel?
Wonderful.
How do you look now when you've changed to that light again?
I am a beautiful tree.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Let's help you get out of this one. In a moment, I'm going to count backwards from 3 to 1. We're going to send a pulse of blue light through the net. This is going to help you to detach from this one. And let's have the angels help you to detach and make sure that you have all your energy into that net as we lift you out. And I want this one to feel this beautiful energy move up and out as we do this. 3, sending that pulse of blue light through the net, swirling through, detaching. The angels are assisting, placing it all into the net. It's all into the net now. Let's gently lift out now. Gently lift out now. 2, almost out, and 1, out in the light of source with the angels. But before you go, is there anything you would like to tell this one?
Thank you for letting me be with you.
Thank you so much. Is there anything this one would like to tell this beautiful tree?
Thank you for leaving. I might miss you.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. And as we cut that final cord and we watch that tree go into the light of source to receive more healing and continue on its journey as a beautiful tree, what color light can we place there for healing?
White.
Beautiful. And as I strike the tuning fork for the color white, I want you to place that frequency there. All those feelings of denser feelings of being tired and thoughts and just falling away. No more pain. As it burns brighter, that more movement in the shoulders and the neck. Let's have Archangel Raphael continue to help and assist us in healing those areas of the shoulder and the neck. How does that feel since we lifted that off?
Better.
Beautiful. Beautiful. And as they continue to heal all of these areas, let's continue with our scan and scan down the body, looking for any low-level energy that should not be there. Any pain or discomfort, feelings or sensations.
Head.
Mm-hmm. What do you know?
A little bit of a headache in my head. I've had headaches all my life.
Mm-hmm. Let's have Archangel Michael place his net of white light around this headache feeling in the head, all the way around where this energy is attached. And as we focus deeper on this energy, what color do you sense this to be?
Orange.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. And as I want to speak to this orange energy, causing the headache in the head, I'd like to speak to it. If it had anything to say, what would it say?
White.
Why is it that you're saying white? Glad to speaking to me.
Light.
Light?
I want light.
You want light?
Yes, this one has lots.
Mm-hmm. So you're taking her light, or what are you doing there?
Taking it and playing with it.
Mm-hmm. And do you ever remember a time of having a human body?
No.
Mm-hmm. And who sent you there to take this one's light, play with it?
Just me.
Yes. And how was it? Continue.
I don't talk to anybody.
You don't. And how did you get to be able to attach to this one? What was going on in her life?
I don't know.
What allowed you to attach?
Grief.
The grief. I see. Allowed you to get in there.
Yeah.
And why are you playing with her light? Why are you, were you set?
There's lots of it.
Mm-hmm. And were you sent here to do anything to this one?
I was hanging around.
Yes. I see. And nobody sent you there to do anything to this one?
No.
Mm-hmm. And so when you talk about playing with her light, what are you doing with her light?
I get it. Mm-hmm. And I play with it like games.
Yes.
It gives her headaches.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It's like I mold it, grab it, make balls out of it.
Uh-huh. And why do you do this?
Because it feels good to me.
Mm-hmm. What other issues do you cause as you're doing this?
Migraines sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
However, she's just got them kind of under control.
Yes. Anything else?
No, just the head and the light.
I see. Well, this is a free will universe, and you don't have permission to be there in this one. Do you understand that?
I do.
Can I show you that you have your own light source that you can play with? It's your own power source.
Okay.
Beautiful. What I'd like you to do is I want you to look deep inside your beingness as a tiny spark. You forgot about it somehow. You forgot about this. Tell me when you see that shining.
I am a spark.
You are a spark. Beautiful. Let's expand your spark out to be larger than what you are. Expand it out there.
It'll come out of her head.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Let's go ahead and expand it out. This is your own internal light source.
It's huge.
Mm-hmm. How does that light feel to you?
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. Are you ready to move with the angels back home to the light source?
Do I get more light?
Let's ask the angels, what do they say about that?
Yes, lots.
Mm-hmm. What else do they say?
I have all I want.
Uh-huh. What do you think about that?
I love that. That's what I want.
Beautiful. So you're ready to go?
Yes.
Beautiful. In a moment, I'm going to count backwards from 3 to 1. We're going to send a pulse of blue light in to help you detach from this one. I want you to help place all your energy into that net so I can lift you out, so we can gently lift you out. I want this one to feel this energy lift off as we did this. 3, sending that pulse of blue light through the net, swirling through the net, detaching, so placing it into the net. It's all into the net now. Let's gently lift out now. 2, almost out, and 1, out in the light of source with the angels. But before you go, is there anything you would like to tell this one?
I love your light.
Beautiful. Thank you for that. Is there anything this one would like to tell this beautiful energy before it goes?
Enjoy your new light. Thanks for leaving mine.
Beautiful. Thank you. Let's cut that final cord between these two. Cutting that final cord. And as we watch that energy go into the light to heal and continue on its journey, what color light can we place there for healing to that?
Yellow.
Beautiful. And as I strike the tuning fork for the color yellow, I want you to place that frequency there into the head. Feel that energy coming back as the dense feelings just fall away. The energies come flooding back in. The pain from the headaches is disappearing. Expansion is happening. Third eye is glowing really brightly now as that frequency swirls outward. Healing as we go. Let's have Raphael assist with the healing to that third eye, that head region. How does that feel?
That's great.
Beautiful.
I have golden clouds swirling in my vision.
Beautiful. Beautiful. We'll just allow that to continue to heal. And let's continue with their scan and scan down the body, looking for any low-level energy that should not be there, any pain, sensations, feelings, or discomforts. Let me know if you find anything.
Just my shoulder area. I just think it's maybe residuals from everything that's gone.
Mm-hmm. Let's go ahead and ask the angels that are with us. Let's go ahead and ask them what this is as we focus deeper on it. What is this?
Emptiness. Mm-hmm.
And is this something, what else do they say?
You're good. Mm-hmm. Nothing else.
And what color light can we, I want to ask them about this emptiness. Why is this emptiness there?
It needs to be filled.
Yes. What color light would you like to fill this emptiness with so we can continue the healing process?
Yellow, gold.
Beautiful. I'm going to strike the tuning fork for the color yellow. I want you to place that frequency in there into the emptiness. Healing and filling that space. It's getting warmer as it swirls outward. The cells come back online. How does that feel since we filled that with the yellow frequency?
Better.
Beautiful. Let's have Archangel Michael place his net of white light around all the energy centers of this one, all the way around the physical body and the energy centers and the energetic body, all the way around. It's a very large net. What I'm going to do is we're going to send a pulse of blue light up through the net, signified by the blue tuning fork. This is going to bring up anything that we might have missed. Sending that pulse of blue light through now. In through the feet. Swirling around the legs. swirling around the root chakra, the sacral chakra, the solar plexus chakra, flowing all the way around the heart, around the throat, around the third eye, and the crown, and then out the crown. And as we did this bring up anything that we might have missed?
No.
Beautiful. Can I confirm a clear scan with the higher self? I've asked the higher self to do a scan and let me know if this one is clear of anything we need to remove today.
All good.
Beautiful. I'd like to do a chakra balance and rebuild. Is that appropriate at this time?
Yes. Throat.
Throat? Anywhere else that you see a fracture?
No.
Beautiful. Let's go ahead. As I strike the tuning fork for brilliant, bright, white light, I want you to envision that fracture there at the throat, sealing back shut, welding back together as I strike the tuning fork. Watch that sewing back shut and welding back together, sealing it back tight so no further can attach. How does that look now?
Perfect.
Beautiful. What color light can we flow all the way around the aura to offer more protection and reinforce it?
Purple.
Beautiful. As I strike the tuning fork for the color purple, I want you to envision that frequency flowing all the way around the aura. As it flows all the way around, it strengthens it. It makes it stronger, reinforces it. This is your armor. And anytime you envision your aura to be weakened, you can envision this frequency, this beautiful purple frequency. How does that aura look now?
Beautiful.
I want you to tell me what stands out to you, what you feel, sense, or experience.
A gentle breeze. Mm-hmm. Butterflies. Hummingbirds. The sun. Mm-hmm. And there's a lake.
Yes.
With the sun shining like a sunrise or a sunset. And it's beautiful, and there's mountains mm-hmm. behind it.
Yes.
And a deer drinking out of the lake.
Beautiful.
And willow trees.
Beautiful. Do you feel you'd like to go visit this lake?
Yes.
Beautiful. Let's go down to the lake and tell me what happens next.
There's no beach. It's just the grass turns into the lake. Mm-hmm. And I look into the lake and I see myself.
Yes. What do you see when you look into that lake and that reflection?
It doesn't look like me.
Beautiful. Tell me what you look like.
Flowy. White hair. Glowy. Kind of a silvery. Mm-hmm. Goldish. Glowiness. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. White robes.
Yes.
Smiling. I feel love and light uh-huh. radiating out.
Yes.
And she's smiling. Uh-huh.
Do you get a sense that you're male or female?
Female.
You get a sense that you're young or old?
30s.
Yes.
Wise 30s.
Yes. And are you holding anything in your hands or wearing any jewelry?
I don't see any.
You wearing my any? Continue.
My hands are out.
Yes.
I don't see any jewelry.
Beautiful. You wearing anything on your head on that white flowing hair?
Oh. Yeah. A small circlet. A very fine gold circlet.
Beautiful. In this gold circlet, does this have a purpose, or is this for just for decoration?
It's energy.
Beautiful.
It's for energy.
Beautiful. And how does that energy flow through that circlet?
Source. Mm-hmm. It comes from source.
And is that gold metal, or is that just light?
Light.
Beautiful.
I thought it was metal. It's light. Mm-hmm.
And tell me where that light, that gold circlet, is positioned on your head. Where's it at?
In the front. Not on my forehead, up higher.
Yes.
Around the crown.
Beautiful. And how does that circlet focus source energy?
It just radiates.
Yes.
I don't know where it comes from. It's like from anywhere and everywhere and above, below. Mm-hmm. It's everywhere.
And what do you do with this source energy that is focused through this circlet on your head?
Radiate love. Mm-hmm. Energy.
Yes.
Light. I emanate it all. Happiness.
Yes.
Mostly love.
Beautiful. And how would you use that energy for others or anybody around you or anything?
Show them love. Mm-hmm. Help them.
Yes.
Love. Positive thoughts, actions.
Does this help to heal as well?
Yes, healing light, heal. Mm-hmm. Love heals.
Yes. Tell me what happens next as you look at your reflection in that lake. And what do you do next?
I touch the water. Mm-hmm.
And how does that water feel when you touch it?
Not like water. It's hard to explain. It's thicker. Mm-hmm. But when I touch the water, I touch myself.
Yes.
I can feel her fingertip on mine. And it fills me with light. And warmth. And yellow. Silver.
Yes.
Love.
Tell me more about the significance of this water.
It's not a gel. It's thick, clear.
Yes.
Beautiful clear water. It has a blue tint to it. I can see the bottom.
What would you like to, what do you see in the bottom?
Rocks. Beautiful colored rocks.
Beautiful. Tell me what happens next.
I jump in.
Beautiful.
I swim down to the rocks. They're not rocks. They're crystals.
Beautiful. What do you see in those crystals?
My reflection. And light.
Yes.
Shimmering. Radiating warmth.
And your reflection in these crystals. Tell me about these reflections. Do these
look? It's the same. Same as what I see when I look into the water, to the lake.
Yes, beautiful.
I have long, flowy, white hair. It's flowing all around me.
Yes. What do you?
I don't need to breathe.
Tell me more about that.
I don't have to breathe. Yeah. I'm in the water. There's. It's like I'm holding my breath, but not. It's like I'm one with the water.
As you look down.
Oh, I see a city.
Beautiful.
An underwater city.
Let's go to that city. And as we go to that city and you look down at where your feet would be, what do you notice about your feet?
It's like I'm a mermaid.
Beautiful.
That's so weird.
Beautiful.
I don't have feet.
And tell me more about your skin. What does your skin look like?
It's translucent. It's I have scales. It's greenish, goldish, turquoise-ish. And my skin is cut. My arms are like shiny sequins, but it's not sequins. It's like it's radiating silver and gold light. I have hands, just no feet.
Beautiful, beautiful. And tell me more about what happens as you swim down to that city. What does that city look like?
It's gorgeous.
Yes.
It's got lots of turrets. Like a castle city with turquoise and green, white, aqua or blue, cream. And I see beautiful fish. And I see other mermaids.
Yes. And as you look into the eyes of these mermaids, eyes are the windows of the soul. Do you recognize any of these eyes?
I don't know. They're all very welcoming. Loving. Want me to come in.
What do they say to you as you enter?
Welcome.
Yes. Anything else?
I just got a name.
Yes. What is the name?
Luala.
Luala?
Yes.
And is that your name?
I think so.
Beautiful.
I go in and there's a king. He has the same hair as I do.
Yes.
Same color, everything. And he holds out his arms to me. And holds me.
Beautiful.
It's my father.
Beautiful. And this is your father in this incarnation that we're living now?
Yeah.
Beautiful.
This is not in this incarnation.
And as you look in that king's eyes, your father.
Yes.
The eyes are the windows of the soul. Do you recognize those eyes in this incarnation that we are living now?
Oh. I don't know.
Beautiful. What does your father say to you?
Welcome home. Luala.
Beautiful. And how's that
feel? I love you. I've never felt anything like this.
Yes.
Oh.
That's, using all of our knowing, where was it that we were at that he is welcoming us back home?
It's not Earth. The garden was a portal.
Yes.
To another world. A water world.
Yes.
And there's no lungs or what, you don't breathe like you normally do as a human. Oh my goodness. I see family.
Beautiful.
And my great aunt is there. Mimi's there.
Beautiful. And what does she say to you?
I've missed you. And she holds me. She's my mother. That's my father and my mother. It makes me so happy.
Beautiful. What else do they say to you?
I'm a princess.
Beautiful. Where did they say that you were at that they missed you so much? That you were gone for so long? Where were you at?
I had been taken. I've been taken by dark ones.
I see. Tell me more about that. How did the dark ones take you?
I was somewhere investigating.
I see.
Away, not at the city. And they caught me.
Yes.
They wanted my light. They did things to me. I was young.
Yes.
But they couldn't take my spirit. And I left.
Yes. Tell me more about how you were able to get away from them.
I didn't. They killed me.
I see.
But they didn't kill my soul.
Beautiful.
I went somewhere else.
So the dark had taken you from the water world?
Yes.
Yes. And then they couldn't take your spirit.
No.
When they killed you, you went back to the water world, that beautiful city?
No. I went to Source.
I see.
I healed.
Yes.
I stayed.
Do you get a sense of why you're seeing this beautiful, this scene of being in that beautiful water world as a princess?
No.
No.
I've never envisioned anything like that.
Beautiful. Tell me more about what happened next after you went back to Source, after they took you.
I healed. They did something to heal me. My soul was hurt. It wasn't a chamber, it was an energy or something.
In what realm or what place was that energy chamber to heal?
It was anywhere and everywhere.
I see.
It's no specific touch place.
Yes.
Like the clouds, like heaven. But no buildings. It was just, well, maybe there were buildings. But I was more of a ball of light than anything else. It almost reminds me of like the, what you would think of like the Greek white arches.
Yes.
That's what I'm getting.
Tell me more about this healing. How was this? How did they do this healing?
It seems like just
in this in-between time.
Energy. Uh, just being there. It was like you go there and you're automatically healed.
And was there other beings in this?
Other balls of light.
Beautiful.
There was a really big one. Like at the center.
Yes.
Huge. Huge orb. Radiating out amazing light.
Tell me more about this huge orb of light that's in the center.
Oh, it's God.
Beautiful.
It is God, and He is radiating everything, all knowledge, all healing. Time doesn't exist.
And does God have any messages for you? And
I'm here to heal people and
yes,
love, teach love, Christ consciousness, don't be selfish.
Yes.
Give. Don't let the dark get you. Protect.
Beautiful. And being in this place where God is, in this in-between times, in-between lives, tell me what happens next.
I recognize some energy sources. Although we're just light.
Yes.
I know. My son's there.
Beautiful.
So is my daughter. My husband.
Beautiful. And being in this high frequency place, we can ask any question we would like to ask in this in-between lifetime. Is there anything that you would like to ask of God or of any of the others that are there?
How? Oh my gosh, there's Yoda. There's my dog. There's Yoda.
Beautiful.
He's there to help me through this life. Some of the questions I had, I don't even know if I need to answer or have ask anymore.
Beautiful. Now the ones that you're recognizing, your husband, your son, your dog, what do these look like in this place?
Not like what they look like now. It's just a feeling.
Yes.
Beautiful. Because they're orbs. It's just, I know that's who they are.
Yes. It's beautiful. As we're in this high frequency place, this in between time with God. One of your questions was, is meeting Jesus.
Jesus is God.
Beautiful.
Which I already knew that.
Yes. Does God have any other messages for you? Anything that you need to hear today?
Keep on doing what I'm doing. It will all come to me in time and when I'm ready. He loves me. And he thanks me for talking to him all the time. I still have things to do. I have a mission to heal.
Yes.
And he won't tell me how to do it. I will figure it out when the time is right.
When he says, or when God says to heal, does this mean heal yourself or heal others?
Yes, both.
Beautiful.
Not physically. Soulfully.
Yes.
I've been afraid.
Yes.
I need to stop being afraid.
How can we stop being afraid? What do you need to do?
Work on myself. Strengthen my chakras.
Yes.
Live in light. I am working on that. I need to do more.
As we are in the presence of God and Source in this beautiful healing place, what happens? Let's ask, what happens when we come into this reincarnation? How is it decided what we are going to do?
I came in to help. To lighten a dark world.
Yes.
It's going to be okay. There's a lot of us.
Yes. And how was that decision made? What does that look like before?
I decided to do it.
And how does the other parts, your soul family, we are all connected, we are all one, but how do we have them help and assist us when we decide to come into this life and do what we're supposed to do?
Strengthen the light. Love conquers all.
Yes. And how is that decided, who is going to help us in this life to accomplish our mission?
It's all volunteer.
Yes. Beautiful.
Karma.
Tell me more about the karma.
Did some things need to fix?
Do you see where those things that you need to fix are?
My husband. He did something to me.
Yes.
I'm forgiving him this time. Breaking the cycle.
Yes.
Need to move on and up. Ascension. Mm-hmm. Have to do it for ascension.
Yes. And so have you been shown what are these areas that you need to work on to aid in ascension? With the karma?
And love others, not self. Mm-hmm. Be helpful. Say no. Mm-hmm. When I need to.
Yes. Explain the love others and not self, because we have to have some self-love.
Too selfish at one point.
I see.
Learn to give. Mm-hmm. Learn to love others and give others. Working on it.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Now, is these karmic debts been paid?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Mother, no.
Tell me more about the mother.
Contentious.
Yes.
What controlling.
Yes.
Fought a lot. Mm-hmm. Not a good relationship until she got sick. Mm-hmm. I think I relieved a lot of the karma, though, because I took care of her and showed her how much I loved her.
Beautiful.
She loved me very much.
Is there any other messages or anything else that this one needs to learn from seeing this scene today of being in the presence of God in the between time where she was healed?
She knows mm-hmm. what she needs to do.
Yes.
Just meditate on it. Mm-hmm.
And why is it that you showed her this scene of her being this mermaid being in that beautiful city as a princess?
The absolute love of the mother and father. Mm-hmm. And that she had everything and lost it. But her soul survived it. Mm-hmm. And she became stronger because of it.
Beautiful. Tell us why she needed to see the scene where the in-between time where she was in the presence of God and place where she went to heal.
Because she wanted to see God and Jesus. Mm-hmm. She knew it was already there.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I wanted to show her some of her soul tribe.
Yes.
There's more.
Is there any other scenes that you would like to show her today that you need to show her? Is there anything else you would like her to see?
There's more, but not now.
Beautiful. I'd like to confirm with you because she's had issues with health issues. I'd like to confirm with you that they've been removed and starting to heal since we removed the entities today. Is it appropriate at this time?
Yes.
Beautiful. She has issues of tiredness, the aches and pains. Are those starting to heal now that we remove those entities?
Yes. It
Beautiful.
will take a while.
Is there anything else that she needs to do to help assist with the healing?
Stop eating junk. More of a vegetarian, organic. Can't have meat. Just be
Yes.
more cognizant on what you put in your body.
And is there any continue? Sorry.
Stay away from scary movies and stuff. If something gets weird, turn it off.
Yes. Could you tell us more about that? There's a reason that she should stay away from scary movies and such.
It will open you up to more things to attach. Be careful on the internet. Spend more time reading, self-help, and gardening. Get your feet dirty. Love your family.
Yes.
Be patient.
The hypothyroidism that she has, what's the cause of that?
Family, physical issue. Tree was part of it.
Yes. And since we removed that, we'll she'll see a difference and start to heal.
Possibly.
Is there anything else we could do to help her heal from this?
Food, iodine.
And is she already taking the iodine as a supplement? And that's something she
No.
beautiful.
She stopped.
So she should continue to take that supplement.
Yes.
The rest of the physical issues that she's been experiencing, have they been removed and starting to heal since we've removed those entities today?
Yes. It won't be overnight.
Beautiful. Is there any other? Continue.
The tree's been there a very long time. Other lives.
Yes. Is there any healing or help required by her physical body at this time?
No.
Want to confirm that. Continue.
Exercise, lose some weight, walk.
Beautiful. And her getting her feet dirty and grounding in nature, walking in nature would be a good idea.
Yes.
Beautiful. Is I want to confirm that all her chakras are spinning and open as they should be and balanced.
Yes.
Beautiful. Is there any AI or implants that are not for her best and highest good that we can remove today?
Yeah. It was hidden deep.
Yes.
And the head. From the internet.
Yes. So it was placed there by the content she was watching on the internet?
Yeah. Long time ago.
Yes. And what is it? What is it doing to her there now? What's happening with it?
It's sitting there. It's waiting.
What is it waiting for?
I don't know, something.
Yes.
Something to wake it up.
This AI needs removed today?
It isn't doing anything. It's just there.
Yes. Beautiful. Do you require any assistance to remove this?
Yes.
What would you like to use to remove this?
Uriel.
Let's call in Uriel. Let's ask Uriel to come in and remove this AI. Take that AI where it's supposed to go, where it belongs, back into its universe, where it belongs. Tell me when that is finished and
it's gone.
Beautiful. What color light can we place there in that area?
Pink.
Beautiful. And as I strike the tuning fork for the color pink, I want you to place that there. Placing that there. Blasting away any of the attachments there that was hooked into, healing that. As that swirls outward, the third eye is coming better online. It's more balanced and burning brighter. Beautiful. How does that look now?
Right.
Beautiful. Is there anything else as you scan the body that we need to remove today that is not for her best and highest good?
No.
Any black magic or negative energy cords?
No.
Beautiful. Thank you. She has a phobia of the dark. Can you tell her where that is from?
Her sister used to scare her when she was little.
Yes.
I told her the boogeyman was going to get her in the basement.
And now that she sees where this comes from, can we release this today?
Yes.
Beautiful. She has a phobia of spiders and some bugs. Can you show her where that comes from so we can release it today?
Bite. She got bit. As a baby.
Let's see. A baby in this life?
No.
I see. And this was the exit point of another lifetime?
No. No, it was. No, I'm wrong. I'm wrong. Her mom.
Yes.
Was afraid.
I see.
I made her afraid.
Yes. And her mother passed this on to her?
Yes.
I see. And now that we've seen where this comes from, can we release this?
Yes.
Is it appropriate to ask her questions now at this time?
Yes.
She'd like to know, is the world going to really get better?
I don't know if I can answer.
I see.
Yes. But it's going to be a while.
Mm-hmm. And is there anything that you can share with us about that?
Timelines change.
Yes.
That's all I can say.
Yes. And since timelines change, is there a chance that we could actually speed up that process?
Yes.
Beautiful. And is there anything we need to know to be doing to help that process along? To help heal everyone and
awaken.
Yes. And when you say awaken, do you mean help awaken others or help awaken ourselves? Yes.
On both counts.
Mm-hmm. How best can we help others to awaken?
Unfortunately, it's hard for some people to awaken. They are living in their own path.
Yes.
And will never awaken. The ones that will awaken are on their own path to awaken. It is their own time to do it. We can give them little pieces of information. They do have to do their own work. We can't do it for them.
Beautiful. So we should still just continue to shine our light and spread seeds.
Absolutely.
Beautiful. She'd like to know, after she come down from Source, where did she go to? Where's she from?
Earth. Other places.
Yes.
I know I can't say.
Can you tell us why you can't say?
I'm being blocked somehow. Two things pop up.
Yes.
The water world. Sirius. And Andromeda. Could be she's been to all of those.
When you say block, is this a block that we need to help remove today? Or is this a block because she is not ready to see this information?
He's not ready.
Beautiful. Thank you so much for that. Are you able to tell her how many lives she's lived here on the Earth plane?
Lots. Thousands.
Can you share with her how her ascension progress is going right now in this lifetime?
Very well. Still has a lot to work on.
Yes.
But she's getting there.
Yes. Thank you for that. And you showed her who of her friends and family are in her soul family. Is this correct?
Yes.
Beautiful. Thank you for that.
She has others.
Uh-huh.
Her grandson.
Yes.
And her granddaughter, one of them.
Beautiful.
And her friend, Annetta.
She would like to know, why did her friend cut her off, not speak to her anymore?
Life path. She's on a different life path.
Yes.
She's learning her own way.
Is there anything else that she needs, this one needs to know about this?
No, if she knows.
Okay. Beautiful. Thank you. And her connection, I believe she saw her connection with her and her dogs today. Is this correct?
Yes.
Beautiful. Is there any final messages for this one? Anything you want her to know?
Take care of yourself. Eat better.
Yes.
Stay off the computer so much. Meditate. Visualize what you really want. And get out into nature.
Beautiful. When we're talking about the devices and the internet, is there any kind of protections that she could use?
Put a bubble over her house.
Beautiful.
She needs it to be up for her job.
Yes. And is there anything that she can do with the devices and the content that's coming through the devices?
She already has a VPN.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Is there anything else she needs to know about the internet and the devices with her working so closely with them?
Be careful. Don't be stupid. She knows.
Can you clarify being stupid for us?
Don't let people know passwords. Don't click on things unless you know it's for you.
Beautiful. I just want to clarify that choice of words. Is there any final message for this one? Are we complete?
We're complete.
Beautiful. I want to thank you for all the help, healing, and wisdom that you've provided for us today. And now I'm asking the higher self to recede with much love and much thanks for all the information that they have given to us today. We're asking the higher self to recede back into the time, space, reality, dimension, and location from which they belong with so much love and so much thanks. In a moment, when I count to 10, you will be wide awake and feeling wonderful all over. 1, 2, feeling the breathing becoming a little faster. 3, 4, beginning to move the arms and legs around. 5, 6, becoming more aware of the room and the space around you. 7, 8, coming up nicely now, nicely now. 9, 10, wide awake, stretching, rubbing, feeling wonderful all over. Get, yeah. How do you feel?
I'm good, stiff.
Wow. Incredible session. Amazing. Wow. And you're glowing now. Look at this.
Oh my gosh. The tree thing. Oh my gosh.
Yeah. That's funny.
You know, when I have my massage therapy, when she does my neck, I've always thought of it as a tree trunk.
Yeah.
because it's so tight and knotted like a tree. Mm-hmm. So it makes so much sense that that was there.
Oh, that's funny. Well, it sounded like the tree for somehow, some way got turned by the dark into a tentacle-like beast.
Yeah.
That was affecting you.
Really weird. really weird.
It was causing a lot of pain and stuff and causing the tightness in the neck and everything. I try to get as much information as I can of what all it's causing, the issues and stuff, so we can heal from it. That's some pretty incredible stuff there.
Yeah. And I could feel when it did the AI thing, I could feel it. And then I started having like almost like with my eyes shut, I could almost see like migraine-y things. Mm. But then that went away. That was weird too. Mm-hmm.
Interesting. Well, and the AI that we took off there, and we didn't take any off on the entity release part, I don't believe.
No.
It was just like the AI.
This one was, and it was back here. I know where it was, and it was hiding. It was deactivated or something.
Yeah, just laying dormant. There's no reason for it to be there. Who knows? And we couldn't figure out who put it there. Oh, the internet. The internet put it there. And I was trying to get protection for you to put over your internet when you're working so closely with devices and computers and stuff. So that way you're protected from any of that stuff getting in there.
Yep.
It was one I posted on the YouTube too, but I had a lady that was a TVD productions manager, and she worked closely with devices and stuff. And one of the protections that was offered to her was using the infinity symbol over what you're working on.
Oh, that's a great idea.
And surrounding it in bubbles of protection. So that way that, you know, nothing can get to you like that. So it's a thought. Whatever works for you, whatever your higher self needs you to do, because you're working so closely with computers.
Yep. And the whole mermaid thing, I'm like, what?
That was absolutely amazing.
That I never in my wildest imagination would that have popped into my head.
Right.
Ever. And as you said, I said things that popped into my head. I let it go and just did it.
Yeah.
So it was interesting.
Like what kind of stuff was the your
everything I said was just from that, whatever.
Yeah. Whatever popped into the head.
Like the name Betty and the name, what was the first one? I can't even remember her name now.
Oh, the little one, Jewel.
Jewel. Yeah, I'm like, what?
Little
Where
Jewel.
Did that come from?
I guess she wasn't too little. She was 7 years old, but still. Yeah. Little one. That's,
I know yeah. what, I know what tree it was.
Uh-huh. Oh, you do?
So, yeah.
Oh, that's interesting.
I don't know if that's where she, it wasn't. It couldn't have been where she was. She must have been hanging out there or something.
Mm-hmm. That's interesting.
Yeah, it was a redbud tree. I used to go lay on it, and I've always had a thing for trees. I wonder why I had this tree in me. So
right, but that's the funny part is, you know, this we have these urges or things that are not ours really. But I mean, who doesn't like hanging out in a tree?
That is true.
But maybe your infinity for trees was a little bit more because you actually had a tree there.
Yeah.
And that was like attracted to it because that's what it wanted to do. It wanted to go back and be a beautiful tree again.
Yeah, well, it got to.
And I could not, it did not know how it got there. It didn't know how it got put there. It just got put there. Something happened that they were able to do that, and it followed you through many, many lifetimes. So
yeah, I'm kind of disappointed that I couldn't find out what other places I was from, but evidently Earth's a big one.
Yeah, you're, so And most of us are. I mean, this is the most dense, the most lessons that we can learn here, and we ascend faster that way. We choose to do it. But it's in dire need too, because most of us are fractals of greater beings that come here to do, like you're supposed to heal. But exactly what you're supposed to do couldn't be revealed yet. With the healing, it's going to present itself.
Yeah, I was hoping for an answer for that, but I guess it'll all come in due time, right?
And so it was amazing because we went to the in-between time where you was in the presence of God. And, you know, I'm letting the session go and I'm like, oh my goodness, we're in the most amazing place. I need to get some of these questions answered that we have. And I always hope I get all the questions answered that we needed to, because we're in that just incredible place. I mean, how much better or closer could you get to God and Source than there? And so that's why I was asking questions of how, you know, when we come back, you know, how do we go through the process of choosing what goes on in this lifetime? How do we make that decision? How's that happen?
Well, I got a little bit that I didn't say because we were just, what I got was that we can't sit because we're just an orb, but we get together and we go over what we're going to do.
Mm-hmm. Oh, perfect.
So yeah, it's kind of a plan with a group. Mm-hmm. I guess that's your soul tribe, whatever.
Yeah.
That you're going to do for that time period.
And then everybody else volunteers and I'll go.
I don't know why you want to come back to this place again, but I mean, it is beautiful. It's a beautiful place. So
I have often thought about that, because, you know, we always talk about the, you know, ascension and everything's going to get better and improve. I can see us, maybe probably especially myself, getting bored with everything being amazing and great. And so I think what happens is, okay, we fixed Earth now, we fixed that realm. Oh,
let's now go this, find another one.
Now this other place, boy, they're in dire need. We need to go over here and do this. So I think it just keeps going on and on and on.
Forever and ever.
I guess maybe that can be kind of boring. But I was also told in sessions, though, that Earth was designed as a, there was many portals here. It was designed more as a vacation planet.
What?
Yeah, it was designed for us to be able to take a break from doing everything we're doing, to come here and enjoy and be in nature and ground and heal. So that's what I've gathered from a few sessions. That's what it was supposed to be, but it got inverted and turned, and it became the slave planet that we're
stuck in.
Now we're all coming back here to fix it.
Yeah.
Because we probably did it. We probably made it happen.
Probably. I watched another lady who does, she's a psychic, and she's like, we've all been on the bad side and we've all been on the good side. And so when you make your plan, you plan on whether you're going to be bad or good. I do think that there are some that are always bad.
I think they might have, maybe I don't always chew that. We're all the same. I don't know if you could always keep choosing the bad side, I guess. I guess maybe that's why they're so stuck, though, because they keep choosing the bad side. And until one of us comes in there and goes, hey, you have the light within you. You forgot that.
Yep. Kind of like the entities that are in people.
Yeah, you're stuck here. They get stuck here and they need help out. So, yeah, I'm not surprised.
Yeah, well, this went way long. I didn't realize it was going to take that long.
Yeah, it took quite a while. It took me, for some reason, the entity release was amazing, but we had removed a lot of stuff.
I had no idea. No idea.
the multiple one that was, it was control. It was the control one was the in one your in lower back. Yeah. But it was running others all over the place. I mean, that had a lot of effects, stomach aches, eating, weight. They were just having a hoota time.
My shoulder feels better, actually.
It's because we moved Betty.
Right. Betty. Betty and her boyfriend.
Betty. Poor Betty. She's 17 years old. But see, that's what they carry the pains that they had. So her shoulder was impacted in that accident as well as her neck. And she's carrying that pain with her still because she hasn't transitioned over to the light. She hasn't made it back to source or back to that healing place that you saw. And until that time, she's still stuck in a stasis, carrying all the emotional traumas and baggage that she used to have.
While my eyes were shut towards when we were doing the chakra work, mm-hmm. I was getting like clouds of colors, just like I was telling you how that happens. It was just crazy doing that.
Hmm. Oh, that's perfect. So then we're balancing those things. You're seeing all the chakras light up through there.
Yep.
I remember doing an attunement. I did an attunement for Reiki, and that was one of the things that we needed to focus on was the colors of the chakras when we did this attunement. And I just remember sitting in that meditation and being, it was like I was in a whirlwind, just whipping me around and balancing all the chakras while I was in that whirlwind. It was pretty incredible.
That's incredible.
So.
Well, this was amazing. Wow. Mm-hmm. That's one of the best things I've ever done.
It's hard to wrap this little mind around the immensity of this.
And your voice changes when you're doing the like when you were putting me under. Mm-hmm. It really wasn't put under because I was cognizant of everything at the same time. It was weird. That, as you said, it's you still hear things. Mm-hmm. But your voice changes. Mm-hmm. It gets deeper and more resonating. It's great. You have a great voice. But
did you watch the wasn't the last session that I posted? Did you get to see that?
Yes.
Where she saw, actually, there's a monk that comes through, and one of my higher selves is a monk that come through and speaks.
I saw that.
I'm like, oh, that's so weird. There's a lot of people say that, and because other people, I mean, the energies affect me and stuff. And as I go into
I'm
it,
sure
it,
they do. The voice. You probably have to go ground yourself now.
I do. I clear out the place and reground and meditate for a little bit. Make sure I use my crystal tuning fork all the time. I take and clear it out with a crystal tuning fork, but it's perfect. But yeah, I've been told that my voice just changes and it starts resonating.
So I downloaded those tuning fork, mm-hmm. digital tuning forks. So do they work just as well as like a real tuning fork or?
Yeah. And what I did though, to get the full sound was I actually went into a recording studio. To make sure. So there was no background because I wanted to use them in my sessions because I can't bang a tuning fork here and these microphones will just cut out. So I needed the full sound. So it's the same frequency. It's just in a recording studio that I recorded them.
Oh, that's really neat. Mm-hmm.
So yeah, you could use them whenever you're in the headset, just bang them. Well, before a session, usually too, I'll run through the tuning forks from root chakra on up and basically do like a tuning right before I start to get everything in line and grounded and connected to source. And then we go on our journey.
You know, my neck's unbelievable. Mm-hmm. It's almost gone. That is so bizarre. I mean, it's still there a little bit because I'm tight.
Yeah.
But wow.
My wife has said that too. Like, she used to be sitting on the fence when I first started doing this, but after her session that she had with Laura, she's like, oh my God, it's amazing. Cannot believe. We didn't even know they were there. They just affected us. You don't even know it. So this was an amazing session. What do you think about sharing this on YouTube?
Sure.
You okay with that?
Yeah, I am.
I mean, I could take out the video too if you don't want your image or whatever on.
Yeah, I don't want my video in there because I was crying and stuff.
Yeah, that's okay. Well, I'll take out your personal information in the video.
I can't believe I cried like that.
Part of the purging, part of the releasing.
Yeah.
And seeing those amazing scenes, I mean, that was very emotional when you were in that water world. That was home.
I want to go back.
Never felt like love like that before, no. Is what you said.
I want to go back there.
It was perfect.
Yeah.
I was trying to get more information on how and what the dark did, and you probably got an idea.
They did things.
Yeah.
Do the kids.
Right.
They wanted my light.
Yeah, I didn't want to go too deep into that. I didn't want to cause any more issues. And yeah. then we went right to source.
I didn't want to, yeah. Well, they tortured me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I figured so. I didn't want to dive into it.
And I didn't get into exactly what they did because I don't think my mind wanted to know.
No, you don't need to.
All I know is that my spirit left.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Went back to source where healing just occurs just naturally. It just happens.
It just happens. In my consciousness, that's how it is. Other people probably have totally different, right. Totally different experiences.
Yeah, and that's what I'm finding in the sessions. You know, the messages is always similar, but there's differences. There's individual. Where's your individual reality? So
that's what makes it so unique. Everybody's different. It's their own thing.
and so it is, and that's how it happens.
Yes.
And that's what happens. It's perfect.
Yeah, you have my permission. Just don't put my video on it and we're good.
Okay. All right, perfect. And make sure you get out and ground. That was told to you. Get your feet dirty. Get out and ground. Get ground back.
I do that in the summertime. I'm really good about that in the summertime.
Well, even just touching a tree.
Grounding.
Taking deep rest too. And that actually getting out and grounding right now actually might help some with the headache too if you have one as well too.
I have several trees in my backyard.
Perfect.
I've already talked to them.
Perfect. And then you might feel like you need rest. Take all the rest you need. Rest and reintegrate and heal.
That was one thing I forgot to tell you before we started this, is my sleep is terrible.
Is it?
Yeah.
You might notice a difference in that too.
Yep. They've been keeping me awake all night.
Oh my God, that's so funny because it just brought a thought. Because who was it? Was it Jewel and Betty? Jewel was the one that kept having that. You have those pains. The arthritis is moving around all over the place. Well, Jewel's trying to get your attention.
Yeah. Thanks.
And then Betty was too. She'd go into your feet every once in a while to try to get your feet. And the tenant of the tree loved to touch the dog.
I don't even remember that.
It's so funny.
I don't even remember saying that.
I wasn't quite sure what you said, or that I think I clarified or something. And the tree, that the tentacle being or whatever, said he liked to touch the dog. Because I asked if it was, because what I'm finding is a lot of the tentacle type entities that we have are actually just like they're reaching and just grabbing energy and things out of the air as they go by and down the street and bringing them into your field, which makes you feel more and more weighted down and just affects you more and more.
So have you seen these tree entities before?
Not, I can see him in my third eye, but I haven't like really got a good image of him. I can see when people are describing him. I can see him in my third eye, and from what they're telling me, that's what they do.
Wow, interesting.
Just grabbing energy out of the air.
Wow.
So, it's their job.
Yeah.
That's what they're meant to do, and it followed you through many lifetimes.
I had no idea. I mean, how would I? But yeah, that was crazy. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I love doing it. So I'm going to edit this video and I'll get it back to you as soon as I can. Make sure you watch it at least once. So to further integrate the knowledge, because it is kind of like a dream. There is some things that we forget.
Yeah.
So absolutely. This is amazing.
Thank you so much and happy holidays. Merry Christmas. And
absolutely.
Merry Christmas. Great one.
If I don't talk to you before, I have a wonderful new year.
Oh, and this is the solstice. Yep. So happy solstice.
It was a good session right on the winter solstice.
Yeah, no kidding. All right.
Perfect.
All right. Thank you. All right.
Love you.
Take care.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Bye. Bye-bye.